الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على سيدنا المرسلين وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي أمري السلام عليكم ورحمة الله تعالى وبركاته dan salam sejahtera. Very good morning to all of you. Pada pagi yang berbahagia ini, saya nak mengucapkan terima kasih kepada pengacara majlis, timbalan-timbalan Net Chancellor, dekan-dekan, Research Alliance Head, tuan-tuan dan puan-puan sekalian. Kita punya sedikit masa sebenarnya untuk membincang. Saya tak tahu kenapa komputer saya berbunyi, tiba-tiba saja saya berbunyi. Untuk membincangkan perkara yang saya nak sampaikan pada hari ini. And the title of my presentation today is Preparation for the 10th Malaysian Plan. I'm going to focus on what is latest in UTM at the moment. Status of transformation plan, branding exercise, repositioning of centers of excellence. We are also planning for new faculties, academies and laboratories, and we are also now finalizing the new procedures for promotion exercise. I would like to mention about new student intake recently. Undergraduate student is 3772, ni final eh, ni final. This is 3772 and 97 students from abroad. They are mainly from Yemen. Sebahagian besar daripada pelajar luar negeri kita daripada Yemen. I'm so sorry, I know that some of you are foreign staff here. I'm trying to be bilingual today, but all my slides, almost all, are in English. So if you are not able to understand my Malay, so please read the slides. Yeah? Our postgraduate student is one-third, which is about 1,322 foreign students. Yeah? We are expecting more to come this week. I'm not sure whether Professor Rose Alinda able to update us with the latest, because we have also other places in KL campus for the registration. But the issue is this. We can see that the drop in the number of foreign students this semester. Yeah? So this is very obvious for foreign student at postgraduate level. Pada peringkat ijazah sarjana lanjutan, ijazah lanjutan, bilangan mahasiswa yang mendaftar menampakkan penurunan. Dan ada beberapa perkara yang kita dapati, salah satu daripadanya ialah kelulusan bahasa Inggeris. The requirement entry on English, TOEFL or TESOL, IELTS. So most students are not able to complete on time. So these are the I think one of the major issues that we have to tackle. Otherwise, I think we will be not be able to get more foreign students in the future. So I think deans, research centers, we have to look into this very carefully. Most students, when they applied to UTM, they applied last minute. Yeah, say for example in March or in April, and they have no time for them to sit for the exams. Probably we can have some kind of new procedures. Probably in Senate this week we can discuss about it, or next week. Yeah. Tetapi yang mengancam kita tuan-tuan ialah buat pertama kalinya sekarang ni pelajar wanita secara keseluruhannya mengatasi pelajar lelaki. More than 50% are female student now dominating this campus. And this is for the first time in the history of UTM we are female driven university. Tepuklah tangan sikit. Ibu-ibu ramai kat sini. Dan yang banyak menyumbang ke arah itu ialah pada pengambilan tahun ini. Pada pengambilan tahun ini, fakulti seperti Alam Banner, majoritinya wanita. FBB, 82% wanita. KSG. Ya, saya ingatkan UKO ni semua orang lelaki duduk tengah panas. Rupanya, Syahrum macam mana ni Syahrum? FKB SK bio perubatan female, ya. FPPSM tu memanglah fakulti wanita. Fakulti sains, fakulti pendidikan semua menjadi fakulti di mana sebahagian besar mahasiswanya adalah wanita. Saya tak menafikan kebaikan perkembangan ini. Ya, sebab anak saya daripada 4 orang, 3 wanita. Jadi kalau boleh tambah lagi lah, 3 quarter should be wanita. Tapi apa yang saya sebutkan ialah this is engineering university. This is technical university, mainly on that. So I think the ratio should be tabulated accordingly. Fakulti kejuruteraan awam, say for example, civil engineering, 54% male, electrical engineering, FKM, ini semua mesin-mesin, tak ada orang perempuan nak masuk, 83% male student. Yeah. Jadi ini perkembangan terbaru yang ada, dan at graduate level, the number, I think there are some mistake here. I'm not sure whether this is correct or not. Malam tadi masa saya buat benda ni, saya fikir mungkin tak betul benda ni. Yeah? Bilangan PhD is 232. 74 are foreign. I think the number of PhD student tu need to be rechecked because data yang dihantar ke saya tu macam-macam. Jadi ini data yang terakhir yang saya fikir harus dilihat balik lah. Yeah? Okay. This is to update you on the student intake. They are starting their lectures today, academic program today. Yeah. And there are a few major events in the university. On 20th of June, Yang Amat Mulia Tengku Mahkota Johor telah berkenan hadir ke UTM. Mentauliahkan pelapis IPTA dan berkenan untuk bersama dengan kita untuk jamuan dan mass night dan seumpamanya. Dan mungkin ada bertanya kenapa Yang Amat Mulia Tengku Mahkota, kenapa tak Chancellor sebagai contoh. Mungkin ada orang bertanya. Pentauliahan pelapis ini dilakukan oleh Yang di-Pertuan Agong. Yang Maha Mulia Yang di-Pertuan Agong. Ya. Disebabkan oleh Yang di-Pertuan Agong tak dapat datang, tak dapat hadir, telah diwakilkan kepada ke bawah Duli Sultan Johor. Dan ke bawah Duli Sultan Johor mungkin ketika itu agak kurang sehat dan telah pulangkan balik jemputan itu, dan Yang di-Pertuan Agong sendiri yang diwakili oleh Yang Amat Mulia Tengku Mahkota. Jadi UTM tak ada kena-mengena dengan jemputan ni. Jemputan ni semua dilakukan oleh Angkatan Tentera, Panglima Angkatan Tentera. Ya, sebab itulah Panglima Angkatan Tentera dan pasukan-pasukan daripada pertahanan negara semua hadir pada hari tersebut. Jadi alhamdulillah kita telah menganjurkan majlis tersebut. Dan yang penting dalam pentauliahan tersebut, selama 3 minggu 1179 orang anggota pelapis telah diadakan 6 pertandingan, ya, macam-macamlah pertandingan kawat dan seumpamanya. Daripada 6 tersebut, 5 dimenangi oleh pelapis UTM. Ya. Ini adalah pertama kali sebuah universiti yang menjadi tuan rumah menang hampir ke semua. Biasanya kalau universiti lain, UKM menang 2 dan seumpamanya. Ya. Sebelum ini di UKM, if not mistaken. Ya. Jadi ini menunjukkan yang pelapis kita di bawah pengendalian Datuk Profesor Alias Muhammad Muhammad Noor, yang kita tengok dia mana ni. Dia pun macam tentera, dia telah mengerahkan semua tentera-tenteranya melompat pada ketinggian tertentu, ya. Dan alhamdulillah, ya, kita telah menunjukkan keputusan cemerlang. And on the 15 and 18 of June, this is very important. I attended, not only me, but about 10 university officials attended Commonwealth Ministerial Conference on Education held in Kuala Lumpur. And during that conference, we met ministers from other countries. 54 countries attended the rep attended the conference, mainly attended by ministers. And we also met various chancellors from various universities. So some of them came to UTM afterwards. Ya, lepas tu dia datang ke UTM untuk mengadakan pertemuan dengan kita dan seumpamanya. Dan saya jangka dalam masa seminggu dua ini sebelum Ramadan akan datang ni, banyak universiti yang akan berkunjung ke UTM hasil daripada pertemuan kita di Kuala Lumpur. Jadi saya harap tuan-tuan dapat mengambil masa sebab ini sangat penting. Dalam pertemuan tersebut, secara spesifik beberapa universiti di Malaysia telah ditunjuk sebagai universiti yang mampu untuk beri sumbangan kepada Commonwealth universities. You must remember Commonwealth University is very prestigious. 25% of the top 500 universities as stated in Time Higher Education Supplement are Commonwealth universities. Yeah, 25%. And we receive the official visit from Sharif University, Iran. Sharif University is considered one of the best undergraduate program outside United States, as reported by Newsweek. Saya pun tak tahu kenapa Newsweek kata macam tu. Tetapi sebahagian besar daripada graduate school in United States, if they want to get student abroad, they can go to Japan or they can go to China. But on top of that, they can go to Iran. And this is the university that they normally go. This university came to UTM, and only UTM for that visit. Deputy Vice Chancellor Research, a few deans, I think two or three of them came. And they came to UTM specifically. They know from the reputation, our reputation, that UTM is their collaborator, the good collaborator, prospect collaborator. So they spent 3 days here. I met them on 22nd, and I hope in the future, not only mechanical engineering, especially in material science, but also in electrical engineering, chemical engineering, and a few other subjects we would like to develop together with them. Yeah. We had UTM, Denmark Technical University, summer course on sustainable production, attended by about 40 students, 21 from foreign countries, Denmark, Italy, Spain, Cambodia, Germany, Poland. So we would like to have such program next year. At least I have spoken to Professor Rose, 10 summer courses. Yeah. Walaupun di Malaysia ni sepanjang-panjangnya sama, tetapi kita meraihkan orang lain yang datang. Jadi bagi mereka sama, kita pun samalah. Ya? Sebab pada pagi ni kita ni winter, saya rasa ni sejuk. Ya? Di bilik ni saya pun kesejukkan seorang kat atas ni. So we would like to have more summer courses in the future with other universities. And we have already mentioned to many vice chancellors we met recently about this program. So it was very successful. Minggu Halan Siswa telah berjaya diadakan 29-30 lepas. Yang berhormat Menteri Pengajian Tinggi hadir dan beliau sangat berterima kasih kepada UTM telah mengadakan Minggu Halan Siswa sebagaimana yang beliau hasratkan. Tidak terlalu panjang dan beri kebebasan kepada student untuk more to reflect rather than to be indoctrinated during Haluan Siswa. Dan UTM adalah universiti pertama yang dihadiri oleh Yang Berhormat Menteri Pengajian Tinggi